will try to wind up as early as possible. So my name is Yugal Kishore Das. I'm living in Michigan, on the Maripa for 24 years. And I visit once in a while to India. And so why not I share the wisdom with my fellow brothers and sisters of India, which where I'm from actually. So the name of the topic is Only Share in the Potential. Before I start, I take one minute. We are all endowed with abundant knowledge, and I'm fine with that. We are all endowed with unlimited abilities, but we should be able to use it right time. You are well prepared, exam comes, you are depressed. Can you bring out your potential? That's what happened one day. I got a phone call. Early mornings, I don't lift my phone because I focus on very important, very urgent thing of my life, mantra meditation. So I was not lifting my phone. Second time, third time, phone is ringing, means something important. I put my weight bag and mantra meditation kit and I lifted the phone. And it is from a girl actually, whom I knew very well. No names. What happened? Immediately she broke down, started crying. I am not going to write the exam. MCAT's exam where Americans get into medicine. What happened? You sounded very positive all these days. No, my preparation is very bad. I'm not going to write the exam. My parents will put me down. My friends will condemn me for my wrong performance. I'm not going to write. I said, look. You did the same thing last year also. Last year also you didn't take the exam. And this year you prepared very well. Now, just 2 weeks before the exam, you are telling this. She said, I'm not going to take the exam. My parents will definitely put me down. I said, look. Let us see how much you will fail. You will get 30%, 40%, 50%. Let us see. This way this will happen next year. So I know you are going to fail. Let us conclude how much you will fail. And this will help you next year. Already you wasted 1 year. That's a real story. She said, no. I'm not going to write. Look, you are going to fail. But what I want to see is how much you will fail. But one thing is sure, you are going to call me every day. Because one line I didn't tell what she said. I want to end my life. Nothing is end of the life. No? Nothing is end of the life. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. So, one thing is, we want to see how much you will fail. You will take the same exam next year. Based on the performance, next year you will come to know where you can start from. She agreed. Every day, one thing, you have to call me every day. Regularly she called, so I pumped, I really encouraged her, enthused her. Don't worry, your parents will not say anything. Don't worry, your friends will not condemn you. And, but I know very well, she prepared very well. Ladies and gentlemen, today she is a doctor. Same year she cleared with the MCAT exam with flying colors, got into medicine. Today she is a doctor. That's what I mentioned in my introduction to stress management. So, we all have unlimited potential. But sometimes what happens? For various reasons, we are not ready to face the reality. We become down, depressed. That point of time, if you have one friend, one counselor, one guide, who can help you awaken that spirit and make you ready for the challenge. Make you ready to face the challenge. I am honest with you, you will do very well. How many of you like this story? Remove her, put her in that place. I pray that you all do very well, like she did. Should I continue? This is a very important presentation. The only problem is time is a constraint. Let us see how it goes. So unleash your potential. Because I have to cut short first line of the program. You should know, you have unlimited power. Somehow I've been in India for 2-3 weeks now. We are going next week, returning back. Somehow Indians don't appreciate the presence of sun so much. We take it for granted. But I am from Michigan, so we love sun because sun doesn't come. Once in a while, he comes just to tell, hey, I'm there, don't forget me. So for that reason, we appreciate sun like anything. The point I want to tell you, you have the same power. The power sun has, that much power you have. That is my first point. So potential, this is the definition of potential from the dictionary. The latent ability or quality that will lead to success. What is potential? The abilities, the qualities we all have that will lead to success. As long as it is not disturbing to them, I'm fine actually. Somebody can do that also. So, this is Brooklyn Bridge. Twice a month I go to New York and stay there. In early 18th century, federal government of America wanted to build a bridge, connecting both the boroughs, Manhattan and Brooklyn. But this bridge is on the ocean. There's not so much technology 120 years ago. So they asked for quotations. One company, they filed a quotation saying that we already built Pennsylvania Bridge. We already built two bridges before, so you should allow us. So government gave the contract to this company headed by Washington Roblin, John Roblin, the father and son. I want everyone to listen. We have background music also. So what is that? The construction started. No, they're able to hear. Can you hear?
Yes.
So the company got the contract, but one day what happened? I'll tell you what life is. Life means change. What is permanent in our life?
Change.
The only thing that's permanent is change. World keeps on changing. Unexpected things will happen in your life. Be ready. So one day there was an accident on the site. The father died on the spot and the son was paralyzed from neck to toe. He was hospitalized. So they want to call off because it was not easy 120 years ago to build a bridge across the ocean, Atlantic Ocean. So that too, father died, son is ready to go. Then everyone called off the work. But the son was determined. I want to somehow do this. And he was paralyzed and hospitalized. But what he did, he came out, he found a code of communication by tapping on the shoulders of his wife. He started communicating to her how to build the bridge. His wife supported the husband, studied strength of materials, studied the aspects of civil engineering, and she started understanding and started decoding the instructions husband was giving. As the instructions were coming from hospital, the bridge was built. You can't believe the person to walk on the bridge was the president of America, but the contractor CEO was not there. He was there in the hospital. He's still there in the hospital. He never walked on this bridge. So person, he was neck to, from neck and below the part, he was paralyzed. But what was his drive? So the point I'm trying to make is, We have that unlimited ability. But if only we purchase that aspect, I have unlimited ability, then you are not bogged down by the shortcomings of whatever happens in your life. Problems will come. Trust me. The way Sunday will come, and after that Monday will come, problems will come. But how you are able to handle it? The resilience, the power to handle the problems, that will define you what you are in future. Next. So I used to work with, I work in Singapore, the software consultant, and DBS Bank. I was into my bank is actually Post Bank. So when I was making this presentation, I made an acronym with this. So these are the qualities we need to possess to become very successful, to unleash, to awaken that potential that we all have. So positive attitude, opportunity for service, self-control, all these qualities. Next. So positive attitude. Actually, I can tell you only one point before I leave this place. Please be positive. I have so many presentations on this. No matter what, never be depressed. No matter what, never be depressed. Be positive. You have unlimited power within you. We are spirit soul. Krishna says, we are all part and parcel of Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, 15th chapter. So as I said, we are a spirit soul as powerful as sun. So I have a video. You can't believe what this video is all about. This person is a very successful person, CEO in the world. But with no hands and legs. Can you believe? With no hands and legs. He was born with a chicken leg, tiny leg. Rather than praying for the whole life, he became a motivational speaker. I want you to watch the video. Then I'll speak.
To think that you're not worth anything. smell so much? And I'm like, well, it's a long story. It's very simple at the same time. You see, it's very hard to smell sometimes in laughter and things that happen that you don't know and you don't understand and you don't know if you're going to get through it. You know, you're going through your storms in life and you don't know how long this storm's going to be.
Audio clearly, he's telling, I was born with no legs, no hands. Rather than crying for the whole life, what I did, I want to make everyone laugh. Amazing, right? He's a CEO, he makes a lot of money. But he's one of the motivational speakers in the world. Only to tell you, you have unlimited potential within you. Rather than crying for the things that you don't have, be grateful for the things that you have. How many of you are understanding? Be here, you have 99 things. Be grateful for the things that you have. But one thing differently, I don't have, you don't have, nobody has. But we always think, I don't have one thing. You're amazing. Your parents are very good. You're doing whatever you're doing. I really do not know you're doing a college. You have a home, you have wonderful parents. Yes, I know, but there's a but. And we regret that's wrong. Be grateful for the things that you have. Whatever you don't have, work hard. But don't be depressed all the time. So, next.
Next slide.
Yesterday I told the story in another engineering college. It's a very inspirational story, but we don't have time. But, she was abused by her husband. She was actually, in 2018, I forgot, International Women's Day. All the successful ladies from all over the world came to Mumbai only to listen from a very uneducated, illiterate lady. Sindhuta Sapkaltiar, she had 270 awards. There was a movie made on her. All the top Bollywood stars wanted to have a picture with her. Why? She studied her life. She studied compassion. She became an emblem of compassion. You know? Anyway, one day, she wanted to end her life. She went on the train tracks with her one-year-old baby, waiting to commit suicide because there was no hope. It was so hot. So it was too much to bear. So what she did, she came to a shade. The tree was cut. Brutally, the tree was cut. But one branch that was cut was hanging down and gave her a shade. Wow, amazing. This tree, so much abused, ready to die, is offering me shade. I should not commit suicide. I should stand up and become a lamplight. Become a lamp, become a leading light for compassion and inspiration. That's when she postponed forever the idea of committing suicide. And she became mother of orphans. They all, many became engineers and doctors, around more than 1500 people. She became mother to these 1500 orphans. The punchline of this story, one day one person came and asked for shelter. That was her husband who almost killed her 20-30 years ago. She accepted him in the orphanage, not as her husband, but as an orphan. She accepted him in that orphanage and told other children, this grown-up baby needs a lot of love because nobody's born cruel. If you develop the quality of acts, service attitude, you will go very far in your life. That is the moral of that story, service attitude. Next. Ladies and gentlemen, very important quality I want to tell you. How many of you want to achieve something in your life? Everyone. Without this, you can't. Without this, you can't. Hey, You are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the intelligence, you are not the ego. When a problem comes, how do you deal with the problem? You will deal with the problem in this premise. I am an Indian, I am born in Daman, I am a woman, I am a girl or a boy. I am in college. With this premise, if you address the problem, your ability to solve the problem goes down by 70 to 80%, because these are all the designations. These are all the, whatever you're thinking you are, that's not what you are. They're all the designations. But if you think, I'm a spirit soul, as powerful as sun, I have so much strength, I have so much potential, I have that inner strength, I can handle this problem. Ladies and gentlemen, if you think like this, the problem will be problem that much, but you will become like Himalayas, problem will become small. So next time problem comes, rather than being depressed, think, I'm a spirit soul as powerful as sun, and address the problem. Problem will become small, you will become big. So for that, what you need? Sense control. Today universities are not teaching that. No university in America is teaching that, no university. I don't know so much about India. You're not the body, you're not the mind, you're not the intelligence. And if you cannot control your senses, if you cannot control your mind, they are your worst enemies. How many of you agree? Your friends will come and say, come for the party. What will mind say? Chalo, chalo, chalo. And the next day, your whole day is ruined. You go for this much enjoyment, and that will lead to this much suffering. I should not have done this. I should not have done this. How many of you thought like this at least? I should not have done this. I am a monk, I am raising my hand, be honest. Raise your hand. Where is mind? You are not the mind. Most of the time, whatever mind suggests you, it is not good for your health. It is not good for your career. It is not good for anything. Actually, I came all the way to tell you this, you are not the mind. Your mind is your worst enemy when you don't control it. Udharet atmanam atmanam. Atmanam avasadet atmayam atmanam undur. Atmanam virupta atmanam. Your mind is not in your control. You are living with your worst enemy. Krishna says in Gita 6th chapter. So, practice sense control. Don't go where your senses are going. Don't go where your senses are taking you. Don't go where your mind is telling you to go. There is one thing called buddhi, intellect, that you sharpen. Police, mind a thief. Don't listen to thief. Listen to buddhi, intelligence. Next. So, next. So, if you resolve to learn this internals of your body, I am not the mind, I am not the body, but I need to strengthen the intelligence and control the mind, you will go very far. Next. So then what happens is, as you go forward, first thing is that this will help you build upon self-confidence. You know what self-confidence means? I can do it. I will do it. I will do it. No problem. I do it. You have to keep on pumping yourself. Because nothing good in this world is easy other than taking alcohol or going for smoking. Degradation is easy. What is not easy? Anything good is not easy. Thomas Edison failed 3000 times when he invented the bulb, and he failed 1200 times when he invented the battery. Somebody said, Edison, you failed 3000 times? He said, no, I didn't fail. Invention of bulb is a 3000 step process. Every time wrong thing happened, everything, something did not work, I realized, I should not try this next time. We all do errors to arrest human. But if you repeat it second time, it is called a mistake. So don't repeat second time. No, be courageous to do errors, no problem. Do errors, no problem. but don't repeat second term. So I have a video coming up, but so build this confidence. Okay, you have failed 10 times. The famous Winston Churchill, who was the Prime Minister of England, when England was controlling the most part of the world, he said, success is not final, failure is not a fatal. Okay, you failed, nothing is the end. No problem, try again. Next. So I have a video coming up. So this is what we do. Wait. It's a minder. I want to tell you this. Yesterday somehow we skipped it actually because I had a, you know, you didn't see that because we had a pointer. That's how you're getting benefited. It's a very wonderful video. When happiness comes, if you expand like a balloon, when distress comes, you'll be like a punctured tire, like a deflated tire. Today, nothing is permanent. Happiness is permanent?
No.
Problem is permanent?
No.
Sometimes problem stays for a long time though. That happiness is probably Sunday evening, 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock, 1 hour.
Yes.
But a problem prolongs. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. Or I don't know what's happening with the career. Dar chal hota hai. Don't worry. So, that's what I want to tell you. Please, very nice with this. Celebrating his victory, but he didn't realize. Success. It comes and goes. Misery stays for a long time. Matras, Varjanas, the Kronte, Sintoshna, Sukadukada, Agama, Payano, Anityas, Tam Titiksha Subharata. Summer will come. Ooh, it'll go. Winter will come. Ooh, it'll go. They come and go. Happiness, it'll come and go. Distress, it'll come and go. But what do you need? Tolerate. Things are not happening in my way. I'm not, you know, I have a problem at home, my parents' problem. My career is a problem, tolerate. My mind is a problem, tolerate. You know? So, tolerate. Develop patience. Very important word. Resilience means ability to pick up and go forward in the present time of problems. They come and go. Don't be depressed. Krishna is telling Bhagavad-gita, tamtidikshasu bharata, tolerate. Happiness, tolerate. Usually people, what they do? Yesterday actually I went to do my mantra meditation. You know, so many boys and girls came, you know. So they were hanging on, I can understand, no, the world is changing. But they don't realize that moment is not eternal. It is only 15 minutes. Again, Monday you have to work. Tuesday you have to work. You know? So, accept what life gives you and go forward. Happiness? Okay, then you will ask a question. So when happiness comes, I should not enjoy? No, you can enjoy. My Lord, I don't deserve this. You have given me. Thank you very much. You got a phone. One day you got a phone call. You are chosen as a Citibank CEO. Congratulations. When he's telling is temporary, should you not enjoy? No, enjoy. But with great gratitude, gratefulness. Be grateful. I don't deserve this, but such a high position, thank you very much. And few days later, you had a phone call. Your dear father or mother, one of the family members passed away. What do you have to do? My Lord, thank you very much. You are telling me the temporary nature of this world. How temporary this world is. For them today, for me tomorrow, one day I'll also leave this place. Maximum 80, 90 years, not more than that. So, utilize the life, not just to enjoy, but to learn and purify yourself, purify your existence. Then you will go forward with that SQ, spiritual quotient. You'll be able to weather the storms, you will be able to handle the happinesses with the equanimity, smartphone. Next. Very important point. You want to be successful in yourself, in your life? What's the point? Believe in yourself. If you don't have belief in yourself, you cannot convince others. Next. So, our brain, why we should believe ourselves? Why we should have belief in ourselves? This is our brain. Brain, inner brain, outer brain. Outer brain talks about facts and figures. And we analyze things. But inner brain, it's called limbic brain. The trust and loyalty. There is no language. This is where you make the decision. So you go to a shopping mall. One sales rep comes. This 15G iPhone is very good for you. Take it. He's speaking very nicely. But something in you tells, don't buy it. In experience? Many of you. Means... He's speaking very well, but something is telling, don't go for it. That is your limbic brain. His facts and figures are great, but something is telling you, don't go for it. Somebody is speaking very nicely, you know, but something is telling you, don't trust this person. That is your limbic brain. Now, my point is this. If you want to be very successful, you should have belief in yourself. So when you are very strong with your limbic brain, when you speak, when you have faith in yourself, when you speak, others will purchase. That's why what is very important? Believe in yourself. I have a friend, passed away, very elderly friend of course, Peter Barwash, one of the famous tennis professionals in the world. And he would speak power. You know, Peter, how is it possible? He said, you believe in yourself, then others will believe you. If you don't have belief in yourself, you know, you say, doubt, then people will not believe. Because you are not strong in your limbic brain. Then others will purchase you. Next. And the very important thing is abilities, ladies and gentlemen. Abilities are important. I have not come here to check your IQ. But abilities means three things. 15th century poet Rupa Goswami, he mentions it. These three words, you make your mantra for the rest of the life. Trust me, you'll go very far. Ready? Utsaha nishya dhairyata. Enthusiasm. No matter what, be enthusiastic. Second one, nischaya. So, we'll come to the nischaya, but enthusiasm. Start with enthusiasm. In the middle, be enthusiastic. At the end, be enthusiastic. Usually, I tell you, I know Indians have Indian. We start with enthusiasm. But after 2 months, tough chal raha hai. Middle people are not enthusiastic. That is where you have to put your enthusiasm. Edison, those days, during the invention of bulb, to create a vacuum was almost impossible. Technology was not there. Just to create a vacuum. Finally, he came out with creating vacuum. What was the next one? Filament. I mentioned this actually in a book. Filament. Tungsten was there, but the technology was not there to take a thin wire from tungsten and make it as a filament. He says 6,000 items he tried. Wow. How many items?
6,000.
And all these colleagues, they were actually getting frustrated. Said, no. He says, start with enthusiasm and in the middle, be enthusiastic. Third one, at the end, be enthusiastic. But that is possible. Next. Only when you have a determination. So when you start in the beginning, you should know what is the end. Most of the people, when they start in the beginning, they don't know what the end is. When you don't know what the end is, then you'll give it up. You should know the finished product. What is it that is going to come out? What's going to happen, you don't know. So, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Next. And now I'm also leading an organization. 2 organizations actually I'm leading. You know? I also deal with hundreds and hundreds of people. It is very easy to, as a software consultant, before becoming a monk, I knew it is very easy to handle 1,000 servers, but it is very difficult to handle 2 people.
Yeah.
But now we deal with hundreds of people, very difficult. Actually, I have a friend who works for HP. He told me this. He handled servers, 1,000 servers from all over the world, sitting in America. He said, very easy. But later they told him, you become an HR manager, and you don't need to manage all the people, but you manage managers. 1-2 months later, they said, I can't do it. But humans are very difficult to handle. But the point is, what is the word?
Patience.
Okay. Things are not happening in the college in your way. Be patient. You are married, your spouse is not listening. Be patient. Children are not listening to you. Be patient. That's why Krishna says in Gita, Tam Tidikshasva Bharata. If you ask me of the 3 things in my life, enthusiasm, determination, patience, third one is more important. Which one? Patience. If you don't have patience, you become angry, you lose. One CEO, I've been cultivating him for so many years, one day he told me, why I did not meet you 20 years ago? Ever since I met you past 2 years, I have not fired you in one gentleman. In my company, everyone is telling what's happening to you. Why you have become so composed nowadays? He said, because of the spirituality he has taken up. Next. And very important. Can somebody read this? You should be a visionary. Visionary means what others can see, you should see. You should be able to see. Then only you will be successful. I have a story, but you know, time is short, I cannot tell. So be a visionary. Visionary means, what is the end product? How will I go there? You should know. I have a story, but I have to go forward. Next. Yes, very important. Actually, I have seen a lot with monks in this quality. You know? Never give it up. Never ever do that. Or piche mone ka nahi. You know, especially if it is confirmed, this is very good for your career. or in family life or spiritual life, never give it up. So, next. So, never give it up means, again, this is connected to the first one. You believe in yourself, have determination, then this negativity is there in us. I can't do it. I'm good for nothing. You are ruining your career actually. Never self-hypnotize yourself, I can't do it. But Einstein also says, when you go forward in your life, you will know, you know about yourself. What you can do, what you can't do. What you can do, what you can't do. Those persons who knew about themselves, they will be very successful. You should know about yourself. So, but when you decide, you have decided to do it, then never do it. Then remove the statement, the self-negative hypnotism. How many of us think like this? I used to think in my childhood actually. There is no question, you know, never give it up, believe in yourself. Next. So there is actually a proverb. Failures are the stepping stones to
success.
But there is another thing you don't know. That when you are not ready, when you don't have sufficient spiritual strength, successes are the stepping stones to failure. Suddenly, today actually, what's happening? I just came from Bangalore, I came from Hyderabad, the high-tech hubs. Youth of 22, 24, they are making a lot of money. When you have so much money, you don't know what to do. You will invariably pick up habits. And become proud. And you start working here. Then when problem comes, you will be depressed. I used to preach in Carnegie Mellon University. And wonder what happened. First batch of people, they got jobs in the Lehman Brothers. Very successful financial company in America. That's it. They started working like this. Became very, you know, how do I say, I don't know, you know, self-imposed superiority. Then another batch came, they got jobs in, you know, first one is Lehman Brothers, then the all big IT companies. I really want to tell them, life means ups and downs will come. Believe me, exactly 1 year later, Lehman Brothers declared bankruptcy. I really thought of them. Actually, you should know, last year, 100,000 Indians were laid off in America alone. Ups and downs will come. Big people like Amitabh Bachchan, whatever superstars, they did not have call sheets for 1-2 years. No movies. So one should not become proud. Things will come and go. So happiness will come and go, distress will come and go. What is very important? Why I want to show this? He's a good example. For former Ravan. Every day he would go and take bath in 5 oceans, drink that water and worship Shivalinga. But what happened? Because he became proud. He started doing mistakes. One day he went to Kailash and he said, I want to meet Lord Shiva. There was Nandi before. Nandi said, no, you cannot see him. Because he's in private quarters. He said, hey, this is Ravan. You don't know? I want to see Shiva. Whenever I want to see him, I should see him. Nandi said, look, private quarters with Parvati, you cannot. And then Ravan became upset. You cannot stop me. You know what Ravan said? You're looking like a monkey, he said. Nandi said, you're calling me monkey? One day, you'll be humiliated. That's how eventually he was humiliated by